Coming out with the four guards and putting a little extra pressure on Southeastern. Start the game going man-to-man once they get inside. Nice shot by Darryl Cohen, and you don't want him to get hot because, as you said, when they beat McNeese in OT the other day, he was the man from the outside.
Cohen had 34 points. He set a new SLC record, making 10 three-pointers. I mentioned he attempted 24 three-point shots. He's certainly not shy about shooting from long range. So keep your eye on number two. That's Darryl Cohen.
What I was going to say, what the Cards don't want to see, though, when they take those outside shots is only one red shirt underneath the rebound. They're going to have to get a little help there. And there you go. Nice move on the inside by Joseph Polite, 6'7", senior out of New Iberia. Southeastern up by four.
You see the Lions pressing the Cardinals, and they're taking a page. They're obviously watching film. Other teams have success when they do the full court pressure on the Cardinals, creating turnovers.
Chappelle, dead ball off the back of the iron. Nobody there to rebound.
Well, again, just Lamar Sanders was the only red jersey there with a chance at rebounding.
And don't expect to see Sanders as the only man inside because got into foul trouble on Thursday, and here he picks up his first one tonight. So you'll see Steven Musa, and you'll definitely see Lawrence Nuevo come into the ball game and give a little help. And, you know, reality is, and you and I talked about this, Coach Rockford talked about this, look around the Southland Conference. You don't see 6'7". As being out of place in a center's position.
Right, you don't see a lot of 6'9", 6'10", no. 7-footers in this conference at all.
So we're back to the free throw line.
Joseph Polite missing. We're seeing a good battle between Polite and Lamar Sanders down low. So far, Polite is winning this one, sinking a bucket and getting the picking up a foul on Lamar Sanders.
Once again, Steve Rockerford on the bench, unlike our last televised game, and told me before the game he was glad to be there. Cards not seeing quite as much pressure this time down the floor. Southeastern going to mix it up, trap a little, go man-to-man full court a little bit. I know also heard him talking a little bit this week about the fact that they like to see Barrow as the true point guard and get the other guys working into the offense. There's some hustle.
Good rebound
by
from
Hopkins.
D-Hop, yeah.
Kicks it back out to Chappelle. Only 2 seconds on the shot clock.
Shot clock violation.
Chappelle tries to take it inside and slap back at him by Kevin Green.
That's the thing with the smaller lineup. If the outside shot is not working for the Cardinals, who do they go inside to? Lamar Sanders.
Well, that's true.
He was double teamed down there and really didn't get a good shot at the goal. Luckily, D-Hop came away with the rebound, but still didn't work out in favor of the Cards.
Well, then you have to start thinking about penetration. How do you break it open a little bit, create a few lanes in there, give the small, quick guys a chance to drive the lane?
Well, I think we saw after the shot clock violation, Brandon Chappelle didn't really have a chance of driving the lane.
No, not really. Basket that time.
Joseph Polite again, his second field goal.
Well, there, you know, and you got that's where the mismatch comes in. You know, if you got Sanders taking care of one big guy, nice easy touch there, then you still got to worry about, you know, a couple of 6'5s.
Curry Todd with that basket, first field goal for the Lamar Cardinals. Remember, they shot a season high 59% from the floor back on the Montaigne Center Thursday night in their win over Nicholls State. Here's that matchup. That's Sanders on Joseph Polite. Polite shooting right up and over him off the glass.
Well, you know, that's not that much of a mismatch. Where you get the mismatch is where it's Chappelle or maybe even Todd having to play up against Polite. And those two guys, 6'1", 6'2". Looks like it's going to be an offensive foul. And in fact, it is. There's Steve Rockerford. First meeting as a head coach against Southeastern Louisiana. Of course, Coach Rock in his first season. And boy, it's been a testing season so far this year. Just this week alone, what he's had to deal with in the media, I'm sure, is something, you know, he hasn't ever had to deal with.
Well, but Coach Rock is great with the media. I'll speak for that.
I think he's
a wonderful, he handles everything. He'll answer any question straightforward and straight up with you. He'll return any phone call. And if he doesn't want to talk about a subject, he'll simply say, you know, that's it. That's all I'll say about that subject. And let's move on.
But it's not something any coach wants to have to talk about when he starts suspending
players. It's an internal matter. It's between him and his players, and he has every right to do, as the head coach, to do that.
There's a foul. And, you know, I think a lot of people may not understand when you talk about team dynamics and what's going on. I mean, you, as fans, you just you watch from the outside, you cheer, you cry when they lose. You know, you're unhappy when things don't go the way you want. And certainly you're a little befuddled when you see a 7-foot-1 guy disappear from the team. But there are a lot of things going on that unless you're on the team or inside the locker room, you're just not going to understand. And I think Steve Rockerford from the very beginning has kind of said, look, these are standards I'm going to hold to, and I'm going to do whatever it takes to make sure that my players know that I have a certain amount of trust right. in them, and they can have a certain amount of trust and confidence in me.
I'm told Coach Rock has four rules. You just follow those four rules, and you guys are they're going to get along great with Coach Rock. If you violate those rules, and then that's when Coach Rock has the trouble with you, whether it's your attitude, whether it's going to class, whether it's your practice time, whether it's how hard you hustle. I mean, these are all kinds of things that will factor into whether you're on Coach Rock's team or not. And what people don't realize is if you're a member of the Lamar men's basketball team, that is a 24-hour-a-day job. Yeah. You are always a member of the Lamar men's basketball team, not just on game day.
Cardinals get the break on the inside. Sanders working hard, but he's going to be called for travel. One too many steps here.
I'm really seeing a different role for Lamar Sanders. He's being asked to be the low post guy, the post up guy, the big guy, and Sanders I think really succeeds in an more explosive role, and we're not seeing that since the Cardinals are starting four guards.
Well, of course, now going to Lawrence Nuevo added to the lineup, and there he is pulling one down. For the rebound, quickly back the other way, Hopkins. Cardinals not really doing much to push the ball tonight. There's the Nuevo. Turnaround jumper off the glass, won't go. Cards down by four, 15-40 here in the first half. Coming to you again live from the University Center here on the campus of Southeastern Louisiana in Hammond.
Foul before the basket.
And with 15:37 left to go, we'll take our first time out of the evening. Come back, continue with more Lamar Cardinal basketball here on KFDM-TV.
Education, entertainment, community, athletics. You're watching the Southeastern Channel.
Bye.
Hey, check this out. Are you ready for college? Well, Southeastern is where you want to be. The faculty's great. And you can study everything from accounting to zoology. Housing's brand new. Technology is top-notch. And money-wise, it's all a great deal. This is all you need to get started. Apply now at selu.edu, Southeastern, where you want to be.
Look at tonight's officials, Bill Lapina, Terry Farr, and Brian Allred. And if you're not familiar with Southeastern University here in Hammond, founded back in 1925, enrollment's about 16,000. And, of course, in Division I Southland Conference. By the way, the University Center, in which you're looking at tonight, 7,500 is capacity. Don't come quite that close to average here in Southeast as far as basketball games. Anywhere from 700 to 1,000 is pretty average here at the University Center.
I think getting a look at the wide shot of the arena here, the University Center, you see why we call the Montaigne Center the crown jewel of the conference.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
This is my first trip here to Hammond, but I've been to various venues here in the Southland Conference, and still when I go back home, there's nothing that compares to the Montaigne Center.
But this is a nice building.
It sure is.
This is,
it
as far as conference goes,
Sam Houston
nice.
State. Yeah. It reminds me of the Bearcats Coliseum.
Cardinals again down by four. Chappelle, Sanders, Nuevo, Hopkins, and Matthew Barrow on the floor. Rebound by Nuevo up
good
and
inside
in.
Pass to Lamar Sanders. That's what works out well. I think Sanders really likes having another big guy in there, and so that makes him more explosive and more of an offensive threat.
Well, I think you'd probably classify him more as a power forward than you would as a postman.
Certainly would. And, that's the role he really needs to be in.
Cardinals need to step up a bit on defense. Not give up the easy point. He'll be out of bounds. Cardinals will take possession on the baseline.
Cards catch a break on that as Darryl Cohen sank a three-pointer right there.
Boy, the guy should be still be tired from last week, Thursday night.
24 attempts from long range. That set a Southland Conference record as well, not only a school record, but a conference record. 24 attempts from long range. Made 10.
Apparently nobody else had a chance to shoot. That's 24.
24.
That's the way you go.
Great job by Nueva with the rebound. That's what the Cardinals need.
Nice move in, but it doesn't go. Quickly back the other way come the Lions. Kevin Green way outside for three. So that'll give Southeastern the 7-point edge. Just under 14 to play in the first half. Cards finding it a little bit easier going, getting it down the floor here ever since the first couple of minutes.
Yeah, Southeastern backed off that press. Yeah, they sure did.
3-3 Reds going to be called for the foul, so that's going to be the second for Lamar Sanders.
We're going to see Lamar Sanders take a bench for Steven Musa, so the Nigerian Nightmares are in with Lawrence Nuevo and Steven Musa, and I did not nickname them that. I believe Coach Rock did.
Also coming in is Samson, the guard.
Ray Samson, one of those sparks that they can get off the bench with his hustle, and he's going to be matched up against number 5, Dacron Nix, who's in the lineup for the Lions. Chappelle on Daryl Cohen.
Going inside, Musa tries to make the move. He's going to pick up the foul.
That's a tough foul on Steven Musa. He came over a little bit late, and it looked like he was didn't even touch ball or player.
Musa again.
Take another look at it here inside. Musa coming over a little bit while his body did get contact.
Yeah, absolutely. For those unfamiliar, again, Steven Musa from Lagos, Nigeria, by way of Redlands Community College. He's a transfer, junior, 6'9".
Ray Sansom getting the rebound on that one. Smallest guy out on the floor.
Barrow up top, playing the point. Here the coaches on both sides talking it out.
Musa hesitated a little bit, but thought if they're going to leave me open, I'll go ahead and try it. Great breakup on that pass right there.
Chappelle moves it forward. Samson, can he take it? No, slows it down. And may wind up throwing it away because it's nope.
No, it was touched. It was touched from behind from Samson, so Cardinals maintain possession. Here's where you don't want Samson to get frustrated.
This is when the Cardinals seem to get in trouble. Nice jam that time by
Daryl Cohen.
Cohen might have hurt
himself. That could be good news for the Cardinals. Not that you want to see a player injured.
No, hung up on the rim, and I think that's when he may have actually hurt himself is when he did that.
And he is not going to the actual coach's huddle. Instead, he's right on the bench, and so we'll update you on Daryl Cohen. He's their sharp shooter, their three-point guy.
Just
taking a bad hop because he didn't really come down funny. Let's see if he comes down on Samson. Oh, looks like a knee. They're looking at his knee.
That or calf.
Yeah.
Talking it over on the sidelines. We'll see if he returns. Of course, if he goes out because of an injury, he won't be able to come right back in. Cardinals once again getting the edge on the inside by putting in Musa and Nuevo.
We'll see if that equals more second chance points for the Cardinals, more offensive rebounds.
Dan Brandon Chappelle had a lights out night on Thursday, really hasn't had too many looks so far. Cardinals unable to come down with the rebound.
Patrick Sullivan for the Lions, number 4, able to control it, although there were a few red jerseys giving him some pressure.
Yeah, a lot of people have been critical. You know, they've talked about, you know, where's the putback? Where's the offensive rebound? You know, we just don't seem to see much of that. Of course, the Cardinals still struggling at this point with the loss of their big man inside, a 7-footer. I mean, that kind of changes the whole shape and fabric of your game.
Well, Sullivan at 6'9 certainly is one big guy that the Cardinals will have to try and battle down low. He just turned around and shot right over Steven Musa.
Musa at the top of the key setting the block. Nice pass. Doesn't go. Musa hustling. Can't get the rebound. Cards ice cold here in the first half from the floor. Musa Campbell, he's got to be called for that one.
And he is.
That's good. Cards only shooting 16% from the field here in the first half. We got 11 and change left to play in the first half. Southeastern up 19-6. Back with more basketball here on KFDM-TV.
Working here is not just research experience, it's not just a job. It's a project to help stop a virus from hurting a lot of people.
What we're trying to do here is to develop a way to inhibit West Nile virus from replicating. At Southeastern, we are able to pull extremely enthusiastic students, perfect for this type of work.
The work we do here is actually going to make a difference in someone's life.
Cardinals trying to find a way to improve their shooting touch here. Unbelievably shooting 16% from the field. Meanwhile, oh, almost got another one. Musa Southeastern at 72%.
Yeah, that's the big difference right now is Southeastern has got really the hot hand in there. Everything they're shooting is falling in, and the Cardinals really can't buy a bucket. So this will change. This game will swing one way or another. They got to take better care of the ball. Luckily, Musa comes away with that.
Musa tries to go inside and throws it away. Obviously, that's not who you want the ball in the hands of.
Well, not
running
the point. Yeah, no.
Going to have a foul here, and I think it's going to be called against Barrow, but I'm not sure.
Hopefully, it's 23, not 33. That would be the third on Lamar Sanders. It is Matt Barrow.
Barrow, so that'll be his first of the evening. And again, Lamar Sanders playing in the game already with two. And they could have just as easily. In fact, I would have thought that it would have been 33 and not 23. So
Barrow's
caught
a break there.
He might have got some help there. Outside three won't go. Cardinals managed to pull it down as it's
good to see the Lions actually miss a shot.
Yeah, Barrow
shooting
going
72% before that.
Musa trying to take it to the hole that time strong.
Well, that could be a game plan.
Well, yeah.
Feeding it inside and let their guys rack up some fouls. So,
well, what you haven't seen, you know, the outside guys played so good on Thursday, but they're getting covered up pretty good. They really haven't had the look so far to even take the clean 3 points.
Musa that whole time was wanting to know where that defender was.
Yeah.
He was leaning as much as he was being fouled. He was leaning into number 22.
Musa knocks down the free throw. Cardinals trying to double up here, get into double figures, trailing 19-7. There's Musa's points per game average. And getting a lot more playing time over the last week and a half, 2 weeks or so.
Yeah, well, both Lawrence Nuevo and Steven Musa will continue to get a lot more playing time the rest of the way.
Cardinals go into a zone. Outside short, and there's the nice rebound. Two players in red battling for it, going back quickly. Hopkins back the other way. There's that open look from Barrow and buries it. That's what they haven't had is that quick release, Mike.
Well, absolutely. That was a great execution down the floor. Matt Barrow scored 11 points in that win over Nicholls State. And so that's what Coach Rock told me during 6 o'clock during our newscast, that anyone up and down on his bench can have a big night. That's what he counts on.
Three back the other way to answer, though.
Kevin Green with the three-pointer. We have yet to see Daryl Cohn, who, remember, either hurt a calf or a knee or something with his leg, come back into the ball game. So some of those other lines will have to step up, and you probably would guess their shooting percentage would go down.
Yeah, Cohn, of course, the leading shooter for Southeastern, averaging better than 16 points a game.
They scored 34 in the overtime win over McNeese on Thursday.
Nice turnaround by Sanders. I think he may have already doubled his point production for the last couple of games. He is at six.
Six, I believe, yeah. He's averaging 4 points over the last two games. So, yeah, he's already above that. But remember, he's got he leads the team in double-doubles. So there was a point where he had seven consecutive double-doubles. There's
nice
a good
pick
steal.
Off there. Sanders the other way. Got a three-on-one. Misses the layup and can't get the rebound.
No putback for Lamar Sanders. Instead, Kevin Green with it.
You're going to have a foul of some kind. Might be a timeout called.
It is indeed, yeah.
Official timeout. Looks like that may be the problem. 7:53 left to play. There you see the score, 21-13. This again, the 30th meeting between these two teams. Cardinals lead the series 17-12. Last time they played, I guess it was I think it was March, wasn't it, in the tournament last year. Is that right?
Yeah, they certainly did. You take a look at the matchups here between Coach Rockefeller and Jim Yarbrough in his second season, Rock in his first season at Lamar. But, yeah, the last win by the Lamar Cardinals was in the first round of the SLC tournament right here in this very building, and they considered it an upset win over the Lions because just 4 days prior, Southeastern right. at the Montaigne Center in Beaumont beat Lamar. And the win in the postseason tournament last year by the Cardinals snapped a six-game winning streak for the Lions over Lamar. So
yeah, and again, as we mentioned earlier, this is a team 2 years ago that went to the NCAA tournament
the
with the automatic bid.
Right.
Yeah. And of course, if you might remember, if I remember correctly, wasn't it Southeastern? Oh, alley-oop slam. Door was open.
Quinnell
Lions
Green
take advantage
on the,
of it.
Enjoyment end of that one.
What I was going to say was Southeastern came in and upset the Cardinals homecoming last year. Then the Cards again returned the favor in the first round of the tournament
they sure
with
did.
A 68-65 win. Ooh, nothing but air that time. Steve Rockford kind of looking out there like, tell me, did I just see that? What happened? All right, 23-13. Cardinals find themselves down by 10 with 7:28 to play here in the first half. You're watching Cardinal Basketball on KFDM-TV.
For sports fans, it's always game time. No matter what the sport, no matter what the season. But for Southeastern Lions fans, all of the games are big. Whether you missed the game or you just want to see the highlights one more time, we'll bring all of your Lion Sports action to you right here.
It's a big game!
Lewis and Clark, great explorers.
I'm Thomas Jefferson. Would you check out the West for me?
Oh, sure. And they take their keelboat up the Missouri.
Oh, Buffalo. Then they built Fort Mandan. There in 1804.
Made some friends along the way. I'm Secretary Weir.
Through the Columbia Gorge.
There are tons of ways to help with your kids' learning. Find the really good ones on connectforkids.org.
A sweet Pacific Ocean.
Back at the University Center, Hammond, Louisiana, on the campus of Southeastern Louisiana. Dan Gresham along with Mike Friedman and the rest of the KFDM broadcast team. Coming up at halftime, we'll catch up on some of the other events of the day. Greg Picazzo back in the KFDM studios with the 5-point credit union halftime update. So what the Cards need a little bit more of right there, misses, and a chance to kind of strike back on offense here.
Yeah, the Cards, after having a season-high 59% shooting from the floor against Nichols, have upped it now to 25% from the floor. Still struggling in field goal percentage. There's Curry Todd.
Nice look. Not going,
great put
but
back
Sanders,
from
oh,
Sanders.
Tries. No foul. A lot of physicality there for no foul. Wow, another one of those three-point attempts. These guys from Southeastern, they're not afraid to put it up from outside, that's for sure. Oh, my, it's going to be a three-point opportunity here as Matthew Barrow goes in with the left hand, lays it up, and gets fouled.
Cardinals had the good advantage there. Barrow already running, and just one guy to beat. Terry Bryant, number 10 right there.
Nice, actually went in with the right hand. I thought he switched over. He'll get a follow-up, convert for three. There's Barrow's stats for the year, and does turn to three-point play.
Cardinals find themselves down by 7. They've chipped away at the Lions' lead. Remember, the Lions were shooting 72% from the floor. They're now shooting 62% from the floor.
Cardinals opting to go for the zone defense, and from the outside,
Kevin Green sinking that three-pointer gives him 8 points. He is leading the Lions in scoring.
He has 8 on the night. Cardinals having a hard time shaking loose to find anything. Pretty good defense by Southeastern. There you see Lawrence Nuevo back into the ball game. Giving Musa a rest.
Allen was tripped and no foul called.
That hurt. You can hear that from over here.
Yeah, Curry Todd takes a fall, and there was a delayed call. They're going to call it out of bounds, and Lamar will still have the ball. No foul call.
Look from floor level. I think he just lost his feet there. I think he just got tripped up. Ooh, that was downtown. Won't go. Quickly back
baseball
the other way.
Baseball pass, and there's...
Nothing else he could do. Good play, actually.
Number 2, Darryl Cohn, back into the game. So whatever injury he had before, he's worked it out.
Barrow made the only play he really had available to him, and that was try to make sure that it wasn't a freebie. He'll pick up his second. Also put the cards at 7, so we go to bonus now. So the 1-1. And that again is the leading scorer for this team, Darryl Cohn at the line. 6'4", he's a senior out of Century, Florida. Averaging better than 16 points a game, but misses his second. Sanders with a rebound. That is his 5th of the night. Again, more than he had in the last couple of games total here in the first half. Nice move inside, and Sanders gets the two-handed layup.
No foul called at all underneath by anyone, and so Sanders waited for both the defenders to go up, and then, well, he went ahead and took his turn.
9-point difference. Cardinals having trouble closing within 7 here in the first half. Again, a lot of that contributed to the fact that they just have not been able to find the basket here early, coming back a little bit as of late, but still only shooting 28% from the floor in the first half. Hard to win games at 28%. Plus, they need a little bit of that right there.
Yeah, Sanders making sure he came away with that rebound.
Hopkins wanted to go inside, but couldn't. Going to have a foul. I believe it's going to be on number 23. That would be Quinnell Green, the senior out of Atlanta, is going to be called.
Well, and you see the Cardinals working it to Curry Todd, and Todd trying to create in the lane. He looks for the open guy, and twice before he's been able to pass it down low to Lamar Sanders. Again, that's what he was looking for right here before the foul was called.
Well, that time, Barrow about to go out of bounds, just throws it up. Down at the other end, though, it's the power jam.
Not much Lamar Sanders could do against Patrick Sullivan right there.
Once again, Cards find themselves down in double digits.
Front of
Todd
the rim.
Tries way outside. Sanders follows and it won't go. And again, the struggles continue for Cards trying to get the ball inside the hoop. That's off. Easy rebound for Sanders. Hopkins finds Nuevo inside. He wanted a foul but won't get it.
The officials letting him play underneath, and Nuevo well short on that.
3.5 left to play here in the first half. Coming to you again from the University Center here in Hammond. Southland Conference basketball, if you're just joining us, McNeese Cowboys going down earlier this evening, giving both these teams, and especially the Cards, a chance to improve their situation, but at this point, finding it pretty tough sledding.
Well, yeah, Cohen now has 9 points and gives the Lions their largest lead.
Going to have a charge foul on Hopkins, a little bit of frustration there, pushes off.
And it'll be the 8th team foul on Lamar, so after this timeout.
3:02 left to go in the first half. Cards find themselves down 32-18. You're watching Cardinal Basketball on KFDM-TV.
Mr. Clutch on the men's track.
Won his team's triple crown, leading the Lions with a 366.
We're named first team all Southland Conference.
Southeastern, a winning season.
Yeah, hustling and making a play.
14-0 against Alcorn.
In soccer, the defending Southland
Conference. Season all for the three-game show.
We would like each candidate to open with a statement.
Thank you and good evening.
This is about choices.
It is a roadmap to our future.
Our region is ideal for growth.
The most pressing needs.
Economic development.
Cutting taxes.
Low incomes.
Public policy.
Good paying jobs.
Steady and consistent growth.
I see that there are great opportunities.
The strength of local communities.
Community.
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 Two left to play in the first half. Again, the Cards struggling here on offense. And again, if you are not familiar with the scenario, during the week, James Davis, Duran Murray suspended indefinitely from the team. John Mertz has left the team. So the Cards shooting up 10 players, but really only 9 will play. One is a redshirt freshman. Can't imagine that Steve Rockeford would put him in and sacrifice a year with only 9 Southland Conference games left in the season. So with that being the situation, the Cardinals going to a forward guard offense, trying to rev things up a little bit. And at this point, they really haven't got it into gear.
Not so far in the game, although they pick up an offensive charge right there, so they take possession. But Coach Steve Rockeford knows he's got 9 players, and including tonight, there are 9 games left in the Southland Conference before that tournament. As long as Lamar works their way in a position to get in the tournament, you just need to put a string of 3 wins together, and you're in the NCAA dance.
Well, really what the Cards need to do here before the half is out is find some offense. If it's Chappelle, you probably don't want to see him shooting quite that far out. That's an NBA three-pointer. Or inside, it doesn't matter. Just find some offense.
Looked like Nuevo thought that one was in for sure. Hit the back of the rim a little too hard and bounced out. Cardinals still struggling from the floor. Last time out, shooting 24% from the floor, 14% from behind the three-point arc.
And Southeastern?
They've lowered a little bit, shooting 56% from the floor. They were shooting 72 at one point in this game. But shooting 56% from the floor, 13 of 23 from the floor as a team.
Sanders way outside. He's short. Going to get his own rebound. Tries to follow, and he's going to be fouled. Boy, Nuevo went down hard.
Yeah, he certainly did. As he went down, though, he stopped one of the defenders from coming over and getting that ball.
There's a look at Lamar
Sanders.
Hopefully
he's not hurt. But, yeah, as Nuevo's down there on the ground, he's blocking one of the defenders. So Sanders looked like he had a clean path.
Nice play that time, though, from Southeastern, just to keep him from getting the easy one, make him go to the line. Knocks down, pushes him to 8 points for the evening. 8 points, 9 rebounds.
The free throw gives him 9. Can a chance to get into double figures.
Not going to happen. So we're under 2 minutes here. Cardinals down by 13. When we get to the half, we will also get you an update on some other games around the Southland Conference. And again, Cardinals have an advantage here if they could find some offense to go up on the McNeese Cowboys in the standings, because the Cowboys lost to Nichols this afternoon, Nichols State 61-53. Wow, downtown.
Way outside, it's Kevin Green, and he's got the hot hand so far in double figures now with 11 points.
Seems like every time the Cards find some offense, Southeastern comes back the other direction, not with 2, but with 3. Back shooting 41% from outside the three-point line. That should be one that would go, you would think. Sanders can't find the hole, though. Left side, right side.
First and second opportunities. How many chances will he get? Certainly just couldn't muscle it up and in. He'll have to earn it from the free throw line.
Take a look. Here's, he tries to go around with
the second
right hand. It doesn't go either. But he'll go the line. Cardinals finally push it over 20, so now the difference 15.
And Lamar Sanders has 10 of those 20 points. 10 points, 8 rebounds. Looks like he's on his way to a double-double, but the Cardinals find themselves quite a bit down.
Make it 13-point difference. Cardinals will see a couple of subs come in here. Like Samson and also
Samson Curry Todd and Shane Mahoney.
Oh, it's Mahoney now that's into the ball game.
Along with Brandon Chappelle and Lawrence Nueva.
No doubt, trying to get a little bit of.
And Mahoney picks up a foul, I think, real quick.
Trying to get a little pressure on these guys, maybe. In this situation, of course, the bonus is going to take him to the line, but. There's a look at the sideline. Of course, Steve Rockeford. First year with the head coaching position, but certainly not his first year at Lamar. Long history of involvement with Lamar University, including the fact that that is where he got his undergrad degree.
And Lamar University grad, Port Arthur Thomas Jefferson High School grad. Grew up in this area. This is where he's from. He knows exactly the type of Lamar team that Southeast Texas likes.
And he went off to see the world. And boy, did he. Here's a guy, Steve Rockeford, Tulane, Memphis, Wyoming. He has seen some good basketball and decided to come home when he got the opportunity, and things worked out. Got a chance to have his first head coaching Division I job at his alma mater. Doesn't get much better than that, does it?
I think anyone would take that.
Guys wait a lifetime for that time. The Cardinals still can't find it. Nice play on a follow-up by Samson that time. Big guys couldn't get it done, but the little guy did just in time. Won't go at the buzzer. 36-23, Southeastern on top of the Cards as we break for the half. When we come back, we'll find out about some of the other sports going on here tonight, also across Southeast Texas. Catch you up on some Southland Conference scores as well. You're watching Cardinal Basketball on KFDM-TV.
Boys and girls, I'm going to give you an assignment. I want you to write.
These kids are in trouble. They're not getting high on drugs or stealing. If they were, you'd do something about it right now. But why is it almost half of all parents who suspect their child has a problem learning wait a year or more before getting help? Why? Kids with learning disabilities are smart. They just learn differently. Call now. The sooner you get help, the better the chance your kid has.
As children, we learn by playing. In time, the competition gets tougher and the lessons have greater consequences. Then one day, we find ourselves on the field of life, where the game is played for keeps and there are no timeouts. It is the mission of the Southland Conference to unite its student athletes and universities in preparation for that day. By building foundations for success with academic excellence. By teaching discipline and perseverance through athletic competition. And by fostering camaraderie and pride in traditions that will sustain our institutions for generations to come. As we ready our student athletes for real life experiences as leaders and team players on the fields of tomorrow, we take this pause to celebrate them all as one by one they prepare for the world, each with their own vision, dignity, and integrity, and the pride of being part of the Southland Conference.
There you see a look at the halftime score. Hi, everybody. Dan Gresham along with Mike Friedman and the rest of the KFDM broadcast crew on the road, coming to you live via satellite this evening from Hammond, Louisiana. And again, if you're not familiar with the exact location of Hammond, it's on Interstate 12, just north of New Orleans, and about 30 miles past Baton Rouge. And again, a beautiful little town, nice little campus. And Hammond is the home for Southeastern, which is about 16,000 enrollment here. And as we mentioned, nice place to play as compared to a lot of places in the conference. This is really quality place. It's 7,500 capacity. Nowhere near that tonight, though.
No, a good venue here, certainly. And they've had support in the past. We mentioned a couple of years ago the Lions were the team representing the South End Conference in the NCAA dance. And so they certainly can draw a crowd. Not too many here tonight.
No.
Maybe a couple hundred.
We'll blame it on Super Bowl Eve. How about that? Okay. Everybody prepping for tomorrow's big game. And a lot of things going on. Really, if you break out the first half here, the Cardinals have just been, I guess the only word I can think of, Mike, is anemic when it comes to offense. They just haven't been able to offer up much. And as you can see, shooting 23% from the field. Well, you're just not going to win games.
Look at that. They're taking more shots. 7 of 31, Southeastern, 14 of 26. But 7 of 31. Certainly, you're not going to be winning any kind of category doing this, especially the point category. You're not going to be winning like that. 1 for 9 from behind
the arc. I was going to say, and a big difference is, when you look at the difference between these two teams in shooting, you got 5 of 12, so you're shooting about, 50% from three-point range versus 1 of 9. This is the same team the other night. It was like they couldn't miss from three-point land. But the difference is this is a better basketball team than the team they faced the other night. There's no doubt about
that. You would think that the Lions have a lot of second-chance opportunities. They're really crashing their glass. But you see Lamar's winning the rebounding total. Lamar with 10 offensive rebounds and 15 defensive rebounds. And Lamar Sanders leading the way. He does have a double-double, 11 points and 10 rebounds so far. But we need to see some other Cardinals step it up to kind of increase some of these categories here so we have a closer ball game.
Yeah, it's interesting that we always talk about, big point production and who's going to be the person who steps up. But the reality is one guy, unless they just have an extraordinary night, is not going to turn things around. You're going to have a team performance. And it's just kind of lopsided at this point in this game.
And we saw it against Nichols on Thursday night at home. The Cardinals had a double-digit lead, but in the second half, the Cardinals were able to come back and take a couple-point lead and down the stretch. And so with about 3 minutes to go or 2.5 minutes to go, it was a nitty-gritty game down there. And so the Cardinals were able to put it together and put a stretch run together. But it took career nights from Brandon Chappelle and Darren Hawkins to do
that's
it.
That's right. And we'll talk about individual performances as we continue to look at things here at the half and see how things are shaping up both for the Lions and for the Cardinals. And also talk a little bit about conference standings because, as we mentioned, some games are already complete and in the books.
Right. We'll update you on that. We mentioned McNeese State losing, and that's who the Cardinals were tied with in the SLC East. So we'll update that in just a bit.
All right. Stay tuned, though. Coming up next is the 5 Point Credit Union Halftime Report with Cardinal basketball underway on a Saturday night.
Wow.
High school graduate, right?
Oh, no, I dropped out.
Oh, well, that kind of narrows it down. Maybe in luck, we have one opening, and it's in advertising.
All right.
Go to OperationGraduation.com.
Well, there's here's a look at our halftime scores. You can see the Cards trailing by 13. Of course, Saturday night is a rocking night in the Southland Conference. I mean, there's just a lot of action going on. And a lot of it, Mike, will have influence on the standings, of course, at the end. You always expect certain teams to win. Then you get a few upsets, and it kind of rocks the boat a little bit and changes things. There you see Arlington winning to over Texas State, 110-103. Also, Northwestern, not much of a surprise there, 78-66.
Yeah, the Demons improving to 7-2 in the SLC East, and they continue to lead that division. You see McNeese falling to Nicholls State. Now, this is in our division, the Eastern Division of the Southland Conference, and that makes McNeese 4-4, while Nicholls improves to 3-6. Remember, Lamar 3-4 entering this game tonight, so with a win, they would tie McNeese at 4-4 and be in third place in the standings. Other scores, you see UT San Antonio picking up just their second conference win of the year over SFA today. SFA falling to 6-3 in the SLC West. And the Lamar Lady Cardinals facing the Lady Lions back home at the Montaigne Center in Beaumont. And that's a close battle right there. 1 point difference with the Lady Lions leading at the half. And, of course, tune into the weekend report tonight with Greg Picazzo. He'll have highlights of that one at 10.
All right, might also mention, when we're talking about college basketball, if you're watching this one, you may not have seen some of the others. Kansas State, a winner over Texas, 73-72, the final in that one, and also a full slate of Big 12 games going on tonight. Some other interesting, I saw Oklahoma State lost as well. Yep. Speaking of games, let's show you, coming up, our next televised game will be February the 22nd. Be home in the Montaigne Center, where a team you may not have seen before, A&M Corpus Christi, rolls into Beaumont. The Islanders will come into town to take on the Cardinals. And again, we'll have a live game for you on Time Warner, Channel 18 at 7 p.m. on February 22nd.
A&M Corpus Christi, one of the newcomers, but one of the highest rated RPI teams in the Southland Conference. And Corpus Christi, 7-0 so far in the SLC West Division. They're currently playing Sam Houston tonight.
All right, Lamar Cardinals, second half, got to find some way to generate some offense. Not that they haven't taken the shots, it's just that they haven't gone down. And again, start off in the hole by 13. Fresh 20 minutes to play. Again, we're glad you've joined us on a Saturday night. Dan Gresham along with Mike Friedman and the rest of the KFDM broadcast crew. There's a move inside.
Joseph Polite starting the way he started the game and going right at Lamar Sanders.
Light now is 7 on the evening. Cardinals going with their original starting 5. Hopkins along with Sanders, Chappelle, Todd, and also on the floor will
Matt
be
Barrow.
Matt Barrow. Sanders trying to deny Light inside. Cardinals going with a man-to-man. There's Sanders again posting up. Rebound by Chappelle.
Well, even though they list Polite at 6'7", he really has an advantage with his reach and his ability to get up off the ground. He really can get over Lamar Sanders. And he can make Sanders adjust his shot.
Sanders that time kind of stumbling a bit when he released the ball. Didn't get off a clean shot.
Remember, Cardinals in the first half shooting 25% from the floor, and they haven't upped it so far. They have not hit a field goal yet.
That's what the Cardinals want to see right there, some dead ball rebounds. 23 shoots the long ball. Barrow misses. Back at the other end. Up and in this time, though, by Kevin Green.
Green actually leading the Lions tonight in points, but Darryl Cohn not far behind. Cohn sitting on the bench for quite a while in the first half.
Green, a 6'5 junior out of Portland, Oregon.
He has 14 points for the Lions tonight.
Going to be called for a hold that time on, looked like they called it on Terry Bryant, the senior out of Hattiesburg, Mississippi. Going to see a couple of changes here. More, again, to a shorter lineup where you can see Mahoney and Sampson come in.
Shane Mahoney and Ray Sampson, excuse me. A much smaller lineup, and that's a quicker lineup. Maybe Coach Rock thinks that'll give the Cards a better defensive shot.
Well, I think he's got to do something to get a little offense generated one way or the other, whether it's based on quickness. Going to have an offensive foul called against, I believe, Sampson stepping in front, blocking off the defender.
Ray Sansom off the bench, picking up a quick foul.
That'll be his first of the evening. Cardinals close to finding themselves doubled up here. And shooting 21%. It's going to be short, but we're going to have a foul called. Second in a matter of seconds on Sansom.
Well, it's going to give Daryl Cohn three shots from the free throw line. We know he's a pretty good three-point shooter. How good is he as a free throw shooter?
Missed the first one.
All right.
Yeah, you'll give up that foul if you keep going from scoring a couple anyway.
Yeah, trade a 3-for-2.
Well, I'd like to trade a
3-for-1.
After picking up a couple of quick fouls, Sampson goes quickly back to the bench. So Cohen will trade the 3-for-2. There's Mahoney up at the point. Trying to give the Cards a little more looks. I'll save that one, will you?
That's two he's made after the foul called.
Bring that same confidence to the next release and see if he can't make one. You say Lions have done a pretty good job, but the Cardinals have not gone without as far as shooting. Chappelle finally gets on the board there with a three.
Chappelle rattles one home, which is nice to see. Brandon scoreless in the first half, so those are his first points of the ballgame. An interesting statistic, Brandon Chappelle and Darren Hopkins both scoreless in the first half of this game, and they both had career nights Thursday night.
Here's a team that shot so well from outside on Thursday, shooting 18% from the three-point line. Cardinals have to collapse, and they do. Nice play by Mahoney to come up with the ball. Five is going to be charged with the call. As he came over in front of Mahoney as he's driving down the floor.
Good job by Mahoney to keep his composure and maintain possession of the ball as he didn't let it get out of control. And wisely let the Lion bump into him to pick up the foul.
Well, you know, the Cardinals have struggled all year with the idea of who's going to play the point, who's going to be the control guard, who's going to be the man that gets the ball up and down the floor. Lots of turnovers the last several games. Like to find somebody who can come in with a little authority. Not afraid to shoot the three. Barrel coming back the other way. It's a 4-on-3.
Hopkins in trouble.
No foul.
No foul called, and he's staying on the bench.
Barrel is
staying
hurt
on the floor.
Well, that's Hopkins. Went down pretty hard on an elbow that time.
Looks like he'll be okay. They whistle the ball dead because Hopkins remained on the floor.
There he goes. Now watch. He tries to push it up and doesn't really have any way to catch himself. So the Cardinals will make a couple of subs, go with the big guys, bring in Musa and also Lawrence Nuevo. This is the first time we've seen this lineup this evening where you go with three of the bigger guys. Of course, if you're just joining us and you're wondering what happened this week, where's that big guy, the seven-footer, James Davis? He has been suspended indefinitely. Steve Rockerford saying earlier this week, it was on Wednesday. I don't know if he's gone for a day, a month, or the season, but he is gone indefinitely at this point and not even making the road trip.
Well, that's the one thing Coach Rock didn't want to do was use the word dismissal. He said he has not technically dismissed them, but has suspended them indefinitely, which could be the remainder of this year.
And them being Duran Murray along with James Davis. And again, forcing the Cardinals to try to think differently, you know, and go with a smaller lineup to start. But again, tonight, a little bit different lineup here. Chappelle, again, with Mahoney and Musa playing the center instead of Lamar Sanders. And Sanders really a lot more of a wingman than he is a postman.
Well, Well, Musa at 6'10 certainly is more of the post position. Kevin Green
continues to add his total. That's 14 for Green on the night. Well, the reason I think you haven't seen a whole lot of Stephen Musa is I don't think Stephen Musa is a real experienced basketball player. He's a kid who's still learning the game.
Right.
Again, played some junior college ball, played prep ball, but does not have the kind of experience that maybe some of these other guys have coming from Nigeria. And Mahoney, no choice but to try to shoot it.
Shot made clock a good violation,
move.
Yeah.
Made a good move because he actually made sure he picked up the foul.
And he'll get to opportunities from the free throw line.
Going to have a break in the action here. 14:26 left to play. The Cardinals find themselves down 45-28. You're watching Cardinal basketball on KFDM-TV.
Music is a language that can be understood in any culture. What I was able to do is incorporate songs that they already knew in Spanish, bringing in the English and having fun at the same time.
I think one of the most exciting things for me as a faculty member was seeing Alyssa develop as a teacher education candidate in a real world setting.
The research goes much deeper than just being words on paper.
It's about creating opportunities through something as basic as singing a simple song.
There's a look at the two coaches involved in this ball game. Steve Rockeford, of course, the Cardinals coach, and also.
We have an official over here at our bench looking to ask to review the last shot to see if it's a three free throws or just two free throws.
The
to see if
happen.
Shane Mahoney would get two or three free throws. And so if our director can replay the, if we have it, the shot before that timeout. Where Shane Mahoney was fouled.
Here right here.
See if his foot is behind the three-point line, and this is what the officials are looking at to decide if he's going to get. It certainly is way behind the three-point line. So he will get three free throws from the charity stripe right now.
Well, that's the advantage of having television and the ability for a playback, because we provide that for the refs, not only for any time during the game, but more. And traditionally, it's for one of those last-second shots.
It usually is. They want to see the shot clock, or they want to see how much game clock is remaining, see if who got the last shot off.
Did he go to OT? Did they make it before? Is he inside? It's a good point.
Interesting to see if they wanted to decide whether he gets free free throws.
Works out nice for the Cardinals, though. Mahoney manages to put him down.
Sinks two of the three. Cards find themselves down by 15. Remember, they trailed by 13 at the half. They have not upped their field goal shooting percentage, shooting 24% from the floor currently, and only one Cardinal in double figures. That's Lamar Sanders with 11.
Sanders managing to pick up the double-double, 11 rebounds, 11 points. Cardinals coming out, pick them up on a little bit of individual pressure there. Mahoney winds up with a big guy, short. Cardinals underneath. Uh-oh, Lamar Sanders looks like he is hurt. Not sure exactly what happened. I saw him clutch his chest. I think he may have just had the breath knocked out of him there.
Yeah. Holding his hands up, trying to catch his breath.
I don't know. I'm not sure exactly. When I looked up, he was bent down on the floor.
Certainly a guy you don't want coming out for the Cardinals. He has the most minutes, 23 minutes, and we mentioned the double-double, 11-11.
But at the same time, if he's out there and he can't play, you don't want him out there hurting you either.
Yeah.
Not at this point, not when you're down by 15. Sorry, make that 18.
Akon Nix hitting the three-pointer. The assist from Daryl Cohn. Interesting to see Daryl Cohn not confident in his outside shot. Instead, he gave it to his teammate.
Cardinals packing it inside. The Wavo and Musa. Musa wide open, but won't take the shot. Chappelle can't get a clean look. Mahoney looking for Chappelle. All he wants is a second, and he can't find it. Inside, trying to go quickly. Nuevo is Sanders, and a little bit too hard. Out of bounds.
Chappelle at 6 foot going up against 6'3", Daryl Cohn, and you see Cohn getting the advantage there, not really giving Brandon a shot.
Yeah, Jim Yarborough, you saw him on the sideline, seventh year of coaching, second year here at Southeast. Actually spent 5 years at Valdosta State. That basket won't count.
It got a roar from the crowd and sure looked nice, but wave it off.
Not sure exactly what.
Number 21, Joseph Polite, being called for the foul. I think it's away from the basket here, but.
There you see the clock, 13 minutes left in the game. Cardinals again trailing by 18. Just throwing it up. I'm not sure if that was supposed to be a pass or a real shot. Didn't look like there's a whole lot of finesse on that shot.
I think Coach Rock would rather see Musa getting the rebound rather than putting up the shot and then no one there for the rebound.
Sanders in. Southeast content to come back and set it out at the top. They're going to slow things down. Well, they should, up by 18. Not feeling a whole lot of pressure here. Shot clock down to 15. Nice play by Sanders that time for a denial. Mahoney goes inside. Nuevo. That was a nice play.
Lawrence Nuevo came off the bench Thursday night with 11 points. He now has 4 on the night, and that's just indicative of the Cardinals' shooting woes.
Good shot of Lawrence Nuevo, the sophomore out of Lagos, Nigeria. Long NBA three goes down for Cohen. And for Cohen, that's going to up his total to 14 on the night. He is 3 of 8 from the three-point line. 51-32, that's the score. Southeast on top, 11:38 to play. You're watching Cardinal basketball on KFDM-TV.
Check this out. Are you ready for college? Well, Southeastern is where you want to be. The faculty's great. And you can study everything from accounting to zoology. Housing's brand new. Technology is top-notch. And money-wise, it's all a great deal. This is all you need to get started. Apply now at selu.edu, Southeastern, where you want to be.
There's a better way to have fun with history.
It's okay, Amelia.
Visit americaslibrary.gov. Log on, play around, learn something.
On three. One.
Well, we're not exactly seeing one of those tonight, but a 20-point difference. Cardinals will have to come alive here and start shooting some threes or something if they want to get back in this one. 52-32 with 10 minutes left to go. Sanders can't even find the handle there and has to kick it out.
Curry time from the corner, and it's no good, and the Cardinals not getting any second-chance opportunities. They did have 10 first-half offensive rebounds. They only have 1 so far here in the second half, an offensive rebound, that is. They are still winning the rebound category, 31-23.
You know, at what point you have to wonder, do you start saying, okay, we're just going to throw them up. You know, we're just going to start shooting bombs, see what happens here. Let's try to get back in this thing. Forget about working it inside. Let's just get somebody open on the outside and take the 3 points, see what we can do.
Well, I would think as a team, and as Coach Rockerford would look at this, is not, you can't score 20 points at once. So
well, you've
got to look at it
2 away.
Points at a time and chip away at it. But I don't know if he's going to just start increasing
launching.
The outside shooting and just start launching.
Well, there's Barrow, picks up the foul as he drives the lane, gets the 2 shots, makes the first, and Cardinals going back again with the short lineup.
Lamar Sanders, yeah, being the tallest guy out there at 6'6". Then you have Curry Todd, who just got that rebound right there. Nice job on the missed free throw. And a backcourt of D-Hop, Matt Barrow, and Brandon Chappelle.
Well, you know, when you go inside, you know, with Curry Todd at 6'4", you're not going to get the free one, but you might get a penalty. You might get the, you know, the penalty shot. And that's exactly what happened that time, as he was hacked by Cornell Green. That's his second. Curry Todd out of Bahia, Mississippi. He's a junior. He's a transfer, as are a number of players on Steve Rockefeller's team this year. And, you know, you got to be honest. What's happened over the course of the last couple of weeks has really kind of rocked this team's world. I mean, you know, from where they were to where they are now, two different teams. I mean, you've taken two major, at least one major ingredient out of the recipe, and that being 7-1 James Davis. And now you've got to say, okay, look, we're going to do what we've got to do, what we can do with what we've got. You know, we're going to be a team that plays with heart, a team that plays with emotion, and a team that plays all out.
And I think this team is confident in what they're capable of. I certainly know Coach Rockerford is confident in that. And you got to remember our last televised game at McNeese State, James Davis was there but did not play one second of that game. And the Cardinals had a 13-point lead in the second half against the Cowboys, let it slip away, unfortunately. And against Nichols at home, the Cardinals had the lead and maintained the lead. Luckily came away with the 89-82 win, and that was without the big guy. So they have had success at some points in time, as we see Curry Todd sinking the big three. So Todd now with 6 points in the game. He's averaging about 8.5. But we see the Cardinals with this recipe being able to have success at times. We haven't seen it tonight so far against the Lions.
Well, even throughout the year, I think it's fair to say that this is a team that struggled to put 40 minutes together. You know,
right.
They've seen 5 minutes. They've seen 10 minutes. But to put a whole game together just really have been few and far between for this team. Once again, coming to you live from the University Center here on the campus of Southeastern Louisiana in Hammond, Louisiana. See that Sanders over the back that time called for the foul. That will be, I believe it's his third. They're showing two, but I believe that's actually his third foul, which for him, good news because he has struggled with foul trouble the last couple of games.
Well, you don't want to see your only guy in double figures getting in foul trouble.
Turns
out to be a good foul. He doesn't get the three-point opportunity.
Mahoney driving down, kind of stopped and
just threw something up.
To force it, yep. Sanders coming down with a rebound. There's an easy drive to the basket that time by Hopkins.
Lyons getting confused on who's supposed to cover him, and he says, if you're going to give it to me, I'll take it.
Cardinals 12 of 45 from the floor for 26%. Meanwhile, Southeastern 21 of 43 for 48%. That really the difference in the game. It's not that the Cards haven't shot. It's just that the ball hasn't gone down. Good denial that time by Hopkins. Knocks the ball out of bounds.
Yeah, Lamar leading the category in second chance points. Also fast break points, 2 points each for each team. So no big difference there. But
wide open look and an easy putback there.
Southeastern also leading in points off turnovers.
Michael Crippen gets the putback there. Cards down by Southeastern. Built up here in the first half and continuing into the second half. Just over 7.5 left to play here in Hammond. Going to be off of Red. White ball. I believe it's going to be off of Curry Todd. Cardinals will hustle to the bench, check things out, talk it over with their coach. We'll be back. This is KFDM-TV, home for Lamar Cardinal basketball.
Robotics is the future. It's a way to actually see computer science practically be used.
What we like to do, we like to get the students involved in doing
experience. Students that are interested in math and computer science here at this university have the support of their professors to do undergraduate research that is unparalleled in the state.
Coming up, our next TV game will be February 22nd, be live in the Montaine Center. You'll see it on Time Warner Cable, Channel 18. It'll be against A&M Corpus Christi, and as Mike alluded to earlier in the game, one of the strongest teams by far in the Southland Conference this year, and they are a new team.
They are a new team, and they have yet to lose in the SLC, so
and
certainly
it'll
be a tough test.
Even longtime Southland fans may not realize that the conference is split into two divisions this year. You have the East and the West division.
Well, that, for the first time ever, the Southland Conference consists of 12 teams. So you split it into two divisions of six, and they'll have the top eight will actually make it into the SLC postseason tournament, but the top two out of each conference will get the advantage as far as getting byes and getting home court advantage.
Oh,
good
no.
inbounds
easy
play right
there
from number 23,
yeah.
Quinnell Green.
Way too easy, probably. 20-point difference again. So, you know, I guess that speaks to the fact that these days you're a small conference. You're not going to get more automatic bids. Doesn't matter if you have 20 teams or five teams. But it's nice to have good competitive conferences, and I assume that's what you get by adding teams.
Well, Coach did say that was the winner of each division, I believe. I believe it's each division. Even if you lose in the SLC postseason
right.
tournament and don't get the NCAA bid, well, you get a bid to the NIT. And while that's not their main goal, obviously the NCAA bid tournament is the main goal, a winner of a division during the regular season gets an automatic NIT berth.
You're going to be playing in the postseason. And that's disappointing, you know, because so many things can happen. You go through the year, you have a great year, but you get into the conference tournament. And the Cards did this, if you remember, several years ago. One of those teams, they really struggle through the year, get to the conference tournament, wind up winning the thing and going to the NCAAs. And it may be that the better team really didn't advance. So it's nice to know that there is at least an NIT bid in there.
Yeah. Well, I mean, the thing with this conference is if you have to just get into that SLC postseason tournament, which will be held in Houston this year, which will be held at one site in Houston, I believe, and the O'Reilly SLC postseason tournament. And the thing is, you just need to put a string of wins together, then play well at the end of the year. If you could put three wins together, which the Cardinals did in Mike Dean's first year here at Lamar, you get into the big tournament, the big dance, and all of a sudden, you know, Lamar's playing a Duke.
Yeah, I start. And listen, it's not so much that idea, boy, okay, they're going to be competitive sometimes with a number, and it always seems to be the Southland Conference bid winds up facing the first or second seed in any bracket.
Sure.
And it's not so much that you're going to, but you have the opportunity, just like last year where Northwestern showed that they could stay, you know, with a top-seeded team in a bracket. And that's impressive because it means for recruiting people, it's the exposure. They go, oh, God, that's a team that went to the NCAAs. You know, the next thing you know, you're picking up one of those players you never had a shot at.
It speaks a lot for the conference, and it helps recruit players here because there is that chance of getting into the NCAA tournament always there for this conference.
Once again, Cardinals and the Lions trading baskets. Still a 19-point difference with just five and a half left to play. That one thrown away as Terry Bryant looked down the floor and thought he saw somebody, but then just tossed it out. So the Cards catch a chance to make up a few points here. Here's Steve Rockford along with his assistants. I think Mr. Skelton's pleased to be sitting on the bench tonight. Don,
not as head coach.
Playing as the head coach, which he had to do a week ago. I assure you that Steve Rockford would much rather be standing on the sidelines than watching the game off the premises.
Right.
Easy inside, but can't get the follow there. I guess Lawrence Nuevo could have been able to put it in. Might have got a three-point, but didn't. Sanders out of the game. So, again, staying with the small guard option, but the big man this time is Nuevo. There he is coming up short. Kind of mad at himself. Knew he had the opportunity. We're going to
see Ray Sansom checking back in. Check in for Curry Todd.
Todd getting some pretty good playing minutes over the last 2 weeks, really. Three, maybe. Nuevo makes two.
Upping his point total to 6 points tonight. Remember, Nuevo off the bench scoring 11 in the win against Nichols. Averaging right at about 8 or 9 points per game.
5:10 left to go. We'll take a break. You have more Cardinal basketball coming up right here on KFDM-TV, home of Super Bowl 41.
Go to OperationGraduation.com.
Checking out some of the other play going on in the conference on this Saturday, and of course moving quickly towards March Madness and beginning right. February. And there you go. UT Arlington, a winner over Texas State, 110-103. Northwestern, once again, one of the powerhouses in the conference, 78-66 over a newcomer, Central Arkansas, to the conference. Nichols State, a big surprise, I think, for a lot of folks today. After losing to the Cardinals on Thursday, come back and beat McNeese, who lost to Southeastern on Thursday in overtime.
And now they lose today, so the Cardinals, were they able to pick up a win or still could pick up a win? Would certainly gain ground on McNeese in the SLC East standings.
Easy drive to the basket. It's going to be off of, look like, number five. That is going to be Dayton Nix, who lost the ball. Nuevo will take a breather. Mahoney will take a breather. So the Cards will bring back in Lamar Sanders, who again leading scorer for the Cardinals. Looking at, I believe he's going to be called for a travel, went twice. Kind of had a stutter step there when he was going up.
Well, he took the hop and stopped, but didn't stay still. And so,
yeah, trying to draw a foul. He's going to hurry quickly back to the bench here.
Ray Sansom coming in, and then, yeah, slid a little bit, and then took a step.
And don't forget, coming up tomorrow, it'll be Super Bowl 41, and you'll be able to see it all right here on KFDM-TV. Getting very early in the day, as you can imagine, with pregame. But if you're having that party, having folks over, don't forget, it is in high def. If you have never seen high-definition television, what a perfect time to check it out, the Super Bowl. As sporting events are just unbelievable how much difference it'll make, the clarity. It's almost like you're there. In fact, some people say it almost looks like a video game when you see it from some of those, like the wire cameras that they move, that they move over the top. Pretty unbelievable stuff. So a great time. And, of course, if you missed it, KFDM-TV, Time Warner, working out a carry situation where you'll be able to see the game if you have digital cable and you have channel 865, I believe it is for most folks. On your digital cable, you'll be able to see it in high def.
Part of the agreement that put the CW back on Time Warner Cable, which if you just have regular Time Warner Cable, that is channel 10.
Correct. And now CW is also up on the high def tier of Time Warner as well. We're elated that tomorrow can be in high def for a lot of folks. And, of course, you also grab an antenna if you already have one, a high definition or a digital antenna, and be able to see the game in high def. As long as you switch off the cable straight to your antenna, pointed towards Viter. And it's true. That's where our tire is. And they're very, these antennas are very directional. So your signal strength will vary. But still could give you high def. It'll be the hit of the party with one of those big 60-inch widescreens and high def.
That would be nice.
Okay,
huh?
Even a 19-inch with high def will look mighty good. And the Cardinals trying to work past this. 64-47. Some folks referring to the earlier part of the week as Black Wednesday. We'll explain why. about what's left to go here. This is KFDM-TV, your home for Lamar Cardinal basketball. Well, if you really want to check out what's happening with this Lamar Cardinal basketball team, probably the best way is get it straight from the coach's mouth. You can do that
That's
tomorrow
right.
night, 11:05, the Coach Rock Show on KFDM-TV. There's
or
a look at the man right there.
Thereabouts 11:05. Remember,
right.
it'll be
yeah,
after
well, I
the
forgot.
Super Bowl.
Oh, that's the Super Bowl. Who knows?
Super Bowl Sunday. And so the news will come on live.
They need to start
Super
the Super Bowl earlier. And I'm convinced, I'm with these guys. Have you seen this movement where they want to turn the Monday after Super Bowl into a national holiday? I
that.
Think they're on to something
that's a
there.
Great idea. Yeah.
Yeah, we're going to call it National Recovery Day. I mean, it's kind of crazy. You have Super Bowl on Sunday, then everybody's bleary-eyed on Monday. Or, what, 40% of all workers don't show up or something astronomical
yeah.
like that following a Super Bowl?
See Brandon Chappelle with his hand in the air asking for the ball.
Somebody needs to ask for it and start putting it up here. Cardinals
Curry
in.
Curry Todd spinning.
Nice move. I'm not sure exactly how he made it. Kind of a prayer thing, but went up and in.
Interesting to make the basket and quickly call a timeout. Coach Rock, obviously, with some specific instructions.
That's one of those that's made before you even go back for the last timeout.
Right.
First basket, we call the timeout. Now you got to work on defense. You got to come up with a big steal and almost an instant putback, and you got to do it several times because the point differential is so great at 14 points. You know, that's 7 2-point possessions. You know, if you get into threes, obviously you can cut it down a bit. But you got to start producing somehow. The Cardinals, again, shooting, they're improving to 28% from the floor.
Wow.
They are 15 of 52. Southeastern, 25 of 52, so they've hit 10 more baskets. They're shooting 48% from the floor. Cardinals going all-court press.
Doing just what you said, trying to come up
yeah.
with a steal or a quick turnover.
Well, either that or they're going to have to come up with a foul. They're not getting one. When you need one, you can't get one. They're going to have to hurry back the other way, take the quick three. Can't stall too long. Nuevo turnaround jumper goes down. Once again.
Race Hansen calling a timeout. So it's make a basket, call a timeout.
Well, 2:42 left to play.
Coach Rock playing as if this was a two-point ball game.
There's a nice look there at that turnaround that does go down. You need to see more of that. You need to see more of this guy. You need to see more of Nuevo, and you'd like to see more of Musa getting into the offensive flow of things. So it doesn't come down to being a Sanders, or it doesn't come down to whether or not a Chappelle or a Hopkins is hot outside, that you get a good balance going. You know, and they've really struggled to find that all year. It's either been one or the other, but not a whole lot of both.
Well, and especially in this game, they haven't found the balance. When you thought D-Hop and Brandon Chappelle had career nights on Thursday, and it's something I asked Coach Rockford earlier during our 6 o'clock newscast, does he need to have those guys step up? Is that what you have to rely on, or can it be anyone on this team kind of contributing? He really played up the fact that it's a total team effort and that they have a game plan. As long as they stick to that, his team will have success.
Coach Rock making some major subs. Wavo comes out. Sanders comes back in. Hopkins comes back in. And Curry Todd comes back in, so actually is starting a lineup back in the game. Sanders under the basket, can't go.
Just short. Indicative of a whole night for the
yeah.
Cardinals, really not being able to find
yeah.
the bottom of the net, even when they're at point blank range.
I think that pretty much speaks for it. You know that old phrase about can't hit the side of the barn?
Yeah.
It's kind of been that kind of a night for the Cardinals. I'm not sure they've found the barn yet. It has been a tough struggle. On the road in Hanman, Dan Gresham along with Mike Friedman, again, the entire KFDM broadcast crew. Nice block by Sanders. Even the crowd kind of out of this one. What crowd there is here at the University Center tonight.
Curry Todd with a chance on a three-point opportunity. Took it the whole way, coast to coast.
I was going to say, if you're not going to make it on the outside, I guess get it on the inside. Nice to see him cut this one. It'd be nice. nice to get it inside at 10 here, but you're under 2 minutes now left in the game. 1:57 left to play. There's Curry Todd, points per game, points tonight, so he's bettered his average. Chance to make it three. Curry Todd will go out. Mahoney will come back in.
So a real small lineup with Ray Sansom, Shane Mahoney, and Brandon Chappelle in. That may be to get fouls.
Yeah, it's a quickness lineup. I mean, you got to do something. And if you don't foul pretty quick, it won't make any difference.
Well, Card's not fouling.
And, of course, Southeastern going to spread it out, going to try to work it corner to corner and force Lamar to foul him or eat up the clock, whichever comes first.
And
now you got a foul.
There's Sansom with the foul. Although a good 20 seconds went off the clock.
Yep.
25 seconds, actually. In that division, so they are still part in the hunt for the SLC postseason tournament.
And I think Coach Rock would tell you it's a long way from being over. We've enjoyed it. Hope you have too. Again, don't forget, join us for the Super Bowl tomorrow. For all the KFDM broadcast crew, I'm Dan Gresham along with Mike Friedman. See you next time. Again, the final 73-64 Southeastern over Lamar.